6 months old, he done 3 months in jail. Here at the bank in his diapers and his little bare baby feet. All he said was, folks, my name is Outlaw Pete. I'm Outlaw.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? For 40 days and nights, people running. say they remain frozen high upon that icy ledge. A young Navajo girl washes in the river, skin so thin, braids a piece of beads, buckskin chaps into her. Saga of Outlaw Pete, soon to be in a bookstore near you. So that was the news that came out this week. On November 4th, Bruce has gotten together with a gentleman named Frank Caruso, who illustrated the book. And Outlaw Pete stems from a book that Bruce's mother, I guess, used to read to him as a child called Brave Cowboy Bill. And so he turned that into Outlaw Pete off of Working on a Dream, one of the LPs we're going to highlight today. And so I thought I'd start out with that, which is, like I said, kind of a neat thing. So, like I said, November 4th, it'll be available hardcover and ebook format. So look for it at a store or internet near you. So my theme today, I wanted to kind of highlight working. We're a Labor Day, of course. Happy Labor Day to everybody. Working on a Dream LP. And then I thought I'd throw a little of the Magic LP in there, too. They were kind of almost bookends as far as his records go. They, you know, came out very close to each other, produced very similarly. And so it's, like I said, I wanted to touch on both of them. Plus, I guess what I really wanted to do in the beginning of the show is kind of touch on a few work songs. He is the working man of rock and roll, so I thought it would be best to let some country stars who nominated him number 17 on the all-time list and what they're most, I guess, awed by is his work ethic. So we'll let them. There's a bunch of folks on here, including Roseanne Cash, Steve Earle, Oak Ridge Boys, Keith Urban, a whole bunch of folks. So give a listen to that, and then we'll go right into I'll Work for Your Love.
The power that he has as a live performer, never seen anyone like him.
And I don't think there's any argument about this. The greatest performer, and I'm talking about Elvis Presley, you know, James Brown, whoever, Bruce Springsteen's the culmination of all that, and the greatest live performer that rock and roll or pop music of any sort ever produced.
He puts everything he's got into every note of every song.
He is a powder keg, man.
That kind of ferocity and passion and commitment and dedication to always coming out and needing to make sure everybody gets connected and elevated and lifted, and giving everything on stage, you know, that's the thing that's always inspired me so much.
He's the best of the best to me. I don't think there's anything that's any better than what Springsteen does as a writer and as a performer.
I can be pretty much anywhere in a car, and if the windows are rolled down, I just want to put it on stun and listen to, you know, screen door slams, Mary's dress waves, you know. You just want to hear those opening riffs, and you're just, it's goosebumps. And how many things do that to you?
Another big thing about Springsteen that I think that artists think about is just the writing, you know. You'd say Merle Haggard's the poet of the common man in country music. I'd say, you know, Bruce Springsteen's the poet of the common man in rock music.
He just keeps his head down and shows up for work, and his work happens to be one of the greatest bodies of work that we have in American music.
I always have this attitude that it's not about impressing, it's about inspiring. And Bruce does that in spades.
We'll be right back.
All right, he's working on a dream. And hopefully you're not working today. If you are, happy Labor Day anyway. So it's a gorgeous weekend. We looks like we lucked out for the most part. We're not a lot of storms. And so, like I said, I just wanted to kind of do a few working songs. He's the working man of rock and roll. And picked a few out of some of his other LPs. And then want to go back to the that LP, The Working on a Dream, and play a few from that and a few from Magic. And we'll wrap another show up. This is Getting Loose with Bruce, with your host, Ray Zirkle, on WRLR 98.3 out of Round Lake Heights, Illinois. We are the voice of Lake County. And like I said, we hope you're enjoying your day off. Bruce used to write a lot of songs based around his father's work life and how he didn't want that kind of life. So did everything he could to try to get into music. And, of course, that worked out okay. But his dad spent endless hours working in different factories. And this is what this next song is based on, his factory.
Walks out in the morning light.
Working on a highway and factory, a couple work songs. Decided I'm going to pop one more in another last work song, rarely played by me. I don't think I've played it even yet to this day. And then we'll go to the breaks and we'll come back and spotlight, like I said, Magic and Working on a Dream LPs. This is Car Wash.
Well, my name is Catherine Fever. Work at the Astro Wash on Sunset and Vine. I drop my kids at school in the morning, and I pick them up at Mary's just for supper time. Well, I work down at the car wash for a dollar and a dime. And mister, I hate my boss, it's at the car wash I'm doing my time. Pick up my
Smart type.
Listening to 98.3 WRLR.
Thank you, Kelly. We are back. And yes, speaking of the station itself, we're going to be doing a radiothon come here a couple weekends from now. I think it'll be the 12th, 13th, and 14th. I don't know if the other DJs have been talking about it, but I know that myself and Wayne from the Wayne's Beatles show, we're going to do probably like 3 hours on Sunday afternoon. And then, from what I'm understanding, it's going to be a nonstop, hopefully nonstop, if everybody, fills in the various hours, the holes, for a 3-day weekend. So I know it's going to start late Friday, probably early Friday evening, from what I'm understanding, after 5-ish or so. And then run all the way through Sunday. So you ought to be in for some treats. I think it'd be kind of interesting. I don't think I'm going to touch Bruce Springsteen the whole, maybe one or two, but for the whole 3 hours we're on, I wanted to come out and do some stuff that I really wanted to do. So I think it'll be kind of fun. And Wayne and I always have had a good rapport here on the show. So we're gonna do a little of this, little of that. So I think it should be fun. So I hope you're all enjoying your Labor Day weekend. I know I am. But I'm here working for you, And now the second half of the show, I wanted to kind of spotlight both of those albums, Working on a Dream and Magic. So, again, a column kind of like how the Beatles used to call their Rubber Soul and Revolver almost album one and two, or side one and side two. These were very similar, both produced by Brendan O'Brien, and very similar sounds on each of them. So, I don't get to play, I really don't play too much from either one that often, so that's why I wanted to kind of spotlight them today. So, next up, Long Walk Home. Looks like my CD is having some issues here, folks. So I'm going to jump over to Working on a Dream. See what I got on here. I wanted to play Tomorrow Never Knows. I like this song. Here you go.
Smile goes. Tomorrow may.
my lucky day. It certainly was on the way down today. I had a guy pull literally right out in front of us and had to do a quick maneuver. So felt that was apropos for today. Again, hope you're having a nice Labor Day weekend. I started off the show with some work-related songs, and then wanted to spotlight the two LPs, Magic and Working on a Dream. So bounced a little back and forth there. That was my lucky day off of on the Working on a Dream LP. And then before that, Girls in Their Summer Clothes. Again, this is technically the last weekend of summer, so you won't be seeing those pretty much pretty soon. They can get pretty darn cold around here. So, and before that, we were doing Tomorrow Never Knows, again, off Working on a Dream. So I was kind of bouncing back and forth there. So now I'm going to go back to Magic, and this is Radio Nowhere.
We'll be right back.
last LPs for Clarence to work on, Working on a Dream, was released in 2009, and he passed away between that and Wrecking Ball, so great to hear that sax solo. And then Magic was released 2007, so like I said, almost bookends. Big, there is a, you know, when I was calling them bookends in the sense, but of their production, the writing is very different, though, in each one. Of course, Magic was a more political, based on what was going on in America at the time with the previous administration. And Working on a Dream, of course, we had a different administration, and all of a sudden the songs became light and fluffy. And a few love songs, so more love songs than probably he's ever put on one album at any time. So, again, we're going to have a big radiothon in a couple of weeks. Stay tuned for more details, and we'll see if, like I said, I haven't seen the official lineup of who's doing what and when, but myself and Wayne will be, Wayne Boyker will be Sunday afternoon. I would think that's the 14th of September. Yep, September 14th, and we're going to be on between 1 and 4 playing all sorts of great stuff. But in the meantime, I'll be back here again next week at 5 and for another episode of Loose, Getting Loose with Bruce. And been reminded that, you know, September 20, well, let's see, when is my show fall in September? On the 27th, his birthday is the 23rd. Oh, we'll have to do it the Monday, the day before, the 22nd. So we'll have a big birthday Bruce-a-loose-loopsa. No, that's not it. Bruce-a-palooza. There we go. His 65th birthday. So we'll have to see what we can come up with. Probably nothing really special, but you never know. But anyway, I'm going to go out with one more. I'm a little afraid to play it only because it's kind of close to the song that was messing up before, but I really want to play it. And so if it starts messing up, I'll switch to something else, or I'll just go to a commercial and leave. So anyway, this is from Magic. This is Last to Die. We'll talk to you all next week. Have a great week yourselves, and we'll talk to you all then.
listening to 98.3.